And now.
Okay, good morning. My name is Lily, and today I'm going to speak to you about orthodontics, which literally means a branch of dentistry dealing with the prevention and correction of irregular teeth as by means of braces. So, a little bit about me. I am a dental assistant. For those of you who don't know, I've been working there for 4 years. And basically some of my duties involve working chairside with the dentist, making the patient feel as comfortable as possible, preparing and setting up for procedures, and doing administration duties like taking phone calls and making appointments, and taking and processing payments. I also set up some payment plans for the patients as well. I also do a lot of laboratory duties, so taking impressions, pouring up models, and making retainers, mouth guards, wow, and bleaching trays.
Wow.
So, also at the practice I work at, orthodontics is one of the treatments that we offer. So, just a question, has anyone here ever had braces before or known someone that's had braces?
Oh, I know someone.
So it's a pretty common thing, especially nowadays it's getting even more common. I myself, I had braces. I had my top ones on for 9 months and my bottom ones on for 7 months. And although this felt like a really long treatment time to me, that's actually a really short amount of treatment time.
Yeah.
So we're just going to get into it a little bit more and what's involved with braces and what we do before putting on the braces. So first off, we'd get the patient to come in and we actually do a consult. So during this consult, we basically talk about what's going to happen. We chart to see if they have any holes in their teeth before that need fixing before we put the braces on. And yeah, so then we start to chart about the chart on the mandible and maxillary, which basically means the upper and lower jaw. So we chart the rough percent of overjet, and I have a picture. So basically, so that's an overjet. An overjet is basically where the front teeth protrude forward. And then we chart the rough percent of overbite. So an overbite is where the top teeth basically cover the bottom teeth, so they're not in alignment. We then also chart what class they're in. So has anyone ever heard their dentist say, you're in class 1, 2, or 3?
No.
Okay, that's what we said. So we chart what class they are in with, basically it's where the teeth come into alignment with each other. So we've got here class 1. Class 1 is basically a normal and healthy relationship between the teeth, where all the teeth meet up correctly and they have an equal bite.
Wow.
So after braces, this is basically considered the perfect bite.
Wow.
Then we have class 2. So that's class 2. So class 2 is an abnormal relationship where the upper front teeth and the jaw project further forward than the lower teeth. So that's class 2. And now I can't find my pictures. And then we also have class 3, which again is an abnormal relationship with the teeth. It's where the bottom teeth come out forward and sit in front of the top teeth. So all these things, they determine how long you're going to have braces for, or depending if you need expansion first. So I am going to talk a little bit about expansion. Sometimes this is an expansion plate. So basically sometimes the first step isn't always to go and put braces on. Sometimes you need to expand the upper and lower jaw so that the teeth can like just fit into alignment normally. So how this works is you've got this little key here, and this is, I guess, the little hole that you do it, and each night you turn it a quarter of a turn. So over time it does go very slowly, but it can be quite like not the nicest thing to do, but over time it does widen the jaw, the upper and lower jaw, so then that way the teeth aren't as crowded and it's easier for the teeth to come into alignment with the braces.
Wow.
This can also sometimes reduce treatment time. So if we start with the expansion plates, sometimes that you can have your braces on for a lesser amount of time. So I'm now going to talk about brackets. This is my little model that I took from work, with permission. So there's two different types of brackets that we use at our practice. We have the conventional types of brackets, and then these brackets here, which are actually called self-ligating brackets. So a little bit of information about the conventional brackets is they are like this, but they have a small either rubber or wire ligature that goes around them, which holds it to the arch wire, which helps the teeth come into alignment along that arch wire. Now these are good. They can come in metal or they can come in porcelain, which is like a clear color. But the thing with this is the rubber and the wire, over time, it does loosen. So you have to go back to the dentist about every 4 to 6 weeks to get it changed. Whereas, I'll pass this one around, with the self-ligating brackets, there's no ligature used. So there's no rubber or there's no wire ligature used, meaning that it's got little clips in, which I can't do because my nails are thin. It's got little clips in, but basically this means that there's constant force on the arch wire. So you don't have to go back as often. You can sometimes go back every 6 to 8 weeks or sometimes even longer.
Wow.
So really you just be going to check that everything's going okay, the brackets are in the right positions and stuff like that. So I just pass this one around, you can have a look. So the good thing with self-ligating brackets is they do keep that constant pressure on the arch wire, which can also, in some cases, eliminate treatment time. So it can be a lesser treatment time because you do have that constant force on there all the time. So yeah, with treatment time, every patient is different. It can vary from patient to patient. No two people have the same teeth alignment. And so in some cases, like when I had my braces, I had my top ones on for 9 months and my bottom ones on for 7 months. I probably didn't need a lot of done. It was just more, just for more looks. I wanted them done and I worked at a dentist, so it's pretty much free. But in some cases, the treatment time can range from 12 to 24 months. With some more severe cases, I've had a friend that's actually had her braces on for 4 years. So that's like, that's a very long time. So just the different severity in cases depends on the different amount of treatment time. Yeah, and like if you're going back every 4 to 6 weeks and you're keeping your appointments and doing what your dentist says, then there's no reason that they shouldn't be moving the way that they should be moving.
Does it hurt getting braces?
It doesn't hurt. There's pain because obviously it's moving stuff and it's sore, but I wouldn't say it's unbearable pain. But yeah, it is sore. It can be sore. Yes, Amanda.
Do you glue them onto the teeth? How do they stick onto the teeth?
Yeah, so to stick them on, you have to go through a little process. You have to first edge the tooth, which is conditioning the tooth surface, and then prime and bond it. After that, then yeah, there comes a, it's called flowable, that we use to stick the brackets onto the teeth. Yeah, and then just cure it all, and then, yeah. Any other questions?
Just quickly, is it the wire that aligns the teeth? Is that the force?
The wire creates the force, but it's actually the positioning of the brackets of what, which will align the teeth. So in some cases, you can have it put on at a first position, and then once the teeth starts to move, you might have to realign that bracket. Yeah.
Wow.
So finishing up in conclusion, ortho or orthodontics is used to straighten and align the teeth and to get an even bite between the teeth and a healthy relationship. This can help the functioning of chewing, and sometimes it's done for just aesthetic reasons, or sometimes it's actually got a medical reason as well. Thank you.